wonderful people, today I have some exciting news for you, and it's all about Stanford's AI module that has been produced or created for college and graduate students. So that is called the storm.jenny.stanford.edu. So it's called Storm AI, all right? And Storm AI generates articles, it generates full-fledged articles. And when you come here, this is the interface anyway. So this is a new session, discover my library. So these are the things I've searched through so far with Storm. The last time I asked it a question, is a virtual supercomputer same as cloud server and all that? I asked some few questions. And today I also used it. So this is my second time using it. Now we are going to click on a new session and then we see how it is. Now, before we start, it also introduces you to some few startup questions you can, like Aristotle's communication model, and some of these are few startup things you can actually try with. So let's try with maybe obesity and weight loss, and it's going to open a new different browser whilst it takes the time to, okay, it didn't take much time. So we can see it generates a whole research paper, a whole paper, a whole article, and you can show as PDF. And one thing is that it includes the table of content, that is a summary, the historical perspective, causes of obesity, and it goes down all the way to, I think it includes references as well. So this makes your work easier. Yes. So this is a very powerful tool. And when you check here, I think this is the paper, as if where the paper is, I think, the paper based on what the paper they wrote for this AI tool, and yeah, assisted in writing Wikipedia like articles from scratch with large language models. So it's using LLMs to write Wikipedia like articles. So I think you can even use this for blogging and for even research students, grad students, and college students. And when you check the GitHub here, the GitHub has information, it has the code, the source code. As I made a video before, GitHub is used to store the source code. So this, I think, is the code, and this is the README file. So the README file has an overview of the Storm AI. So it gives us an overview. So it says pre-writing stage, it gives you the topic. Then it produces the outline, as you've seen over here. This is the outline, and then references. So this is a powerful tool. And then the references, then that's the pre-writing, then it's research via the question asking, and it generates the writing, the full-fledged article, full-length article for you. And you know, we have both Storm, that is, if you switch the button to the right side, it goes to CoStorm. If you switch to the left side, it goes to Storm. Okay, now when we read the GitHub, it says perspective guided question asking. So for Storm, when you are given an input, like as if you give it an input, it discovers Storm discovers different perspectives by surveying existing articles from similar topics and uses them to control the question asking process. And it simulated conversations, and the Storm simulates a conversation between a Wikipedia writer and a topic expert grounded in internet sources to enable the language model to update its understanding of the topic and ask follow-up questions. Yeah, so for this, you can also still ask follow-up questions like that, all right? Now, the next thing is we have the CoStorm. The CoStorm is use LLM experts. This is the type of agent. This type of agent generates answers grounded on external knowledge and all that. So this is the procedure. This is all that it talks about. So we are going to explore a bit of it. Now, I want to use Aristotle communication or obesity and weight loss. And so let me just click on CoStorm and click on obesity and weight loss. And I think it is going to, with CoStorm, we have to actually, it collaborates with CoStorm also requires human collaboration. So you'll be giving it some questions. So, can you tell us the things to do to stay fit and not become obese? Okay, so I click on this. You say, please wait until the current speaker has finished before submitting. Okay. Before submitting your utterance. Okay. Okay, so we wait for it. So as we keep on waiting, whilst we keep on waiting, we explore other parts of Ostrom. So I put in my research article here, and I asked it about my research topic, and it gave me the summary, the background, the key. This is what we do now in our work, like in this paper. So circular scriptography, it involves the key generation process, the public key distribution, the security model. Yeah, this is, I think this is on point. And now if I click on reference three, it says fundamental cryptography, blah blah blah. So it shows me the reference. When I click on reference five, it uses Planck. Then when I click on research reference six, I think it took this paper from a journal. So that is it. Now let me check on reference two from this paper. Yeah, it checked MDPI. This is an open access journal. So it took resources from them. So I think this is very good. It's great, I would say. Let's check on our previous stuff, whether it's done. Oh. Okay, I don't know what is going on, but let's see what is going on. And let me see why it's keeping long. I don't know why. Okay, so we can see that from here. Sorry, we can see from here. It generates everything. And one more thing is that we can actually see the brainstorming process. So the brainstorming process, here it talks about IoT specialists. What are some specific use cases where circular cryptography has been effectively implemented in IoT environments? And it gives a whole, literature on that. What are the main challenges and what? And cybersecurity professional. So this is an IoT specialist. So this is a response based on an IoT specialist. And this editor will explore how circular cryptography can be integrated into IoT devices and blah blah blah. Then cybersecurity professional also gives his own perspective on this. Then a cyber cryptography expert also gives his own perspective on this, and basic fact writer, like normal layman. All right, so maybe I will be in this option because I write cryptography models. So, and it says circular cryptography is a modern cryptography paradigm designed to blah 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 avoid key scroll problem. Yeah, so this is perfect. I feel this is perfect. This is perfect. This is perfect. This is so good. So we can actually check on the outline, and maybe we can check on. I mentioned it should give me future directions. And future directions, it talked about integration of blockchain technology, zero trust models, and a whole lot. Let me see if my cold storm is working. Okay, I don't know why my cold storm is delaying. Let me just ask the question. Differences between a fit model and obese model. Sorry, I'm just using an example. And here I just stick to custom. Can you outline what makes people what slim models go through and what fat models also go through, sorry. And let me click on this start. So I wait for it to compare. I think this is not working. I don't know what is going on, but I think that is it. And then after we discover, I think it, with time, the Stanford University is going to improve their model. Now, one thing I also want to show you is on SciSpace. SciSpace is also a very powerful tool, and it's also very essential for researchers. And this is SciSpace. I've been using SciSpace for some time, and I say it's a good offer, trust me. And this is a SciSpace. This is you can chat with PDF. When you go to the website, it has my library, my notebooks, my profile. I bought that subscription, and then literature review, AI writer, find topics, and paraphrase, such citation generator, extract data, AI detector, PDF to video, and all that. So when I click on home, I go to my library. I can search for those in China, you can buy this on Taobao. You can buy it for a few days, 7 days, and a whole lot of that. Okay. So these are I think notebooks people have created. And this is my profile. No, I use a public profile because I bought the subscription. And somebody put in a video. Let's see this. Okay, let's see this. And somebody put in a video, and it got it. I think the person put in some videos and then generated some PDF slides. Let's see how that works too. Welcome to our presentation. Because the Chinese people can speak English too well, so this AI is very essential for them, very beneficial for them. Although it's not only them, but it's also essential for everybody. And you can see it generated a whole video into some PDF slides. Yeah, I think this is not bad. Yeah. And when we go to chat with PDF, which I use it often, I upload a PDF. I'm going to upload a PDF from my computer, and then we are going to chat with the PDF. So I go to, which PDF do I use? Okay, let me just check paper 6. Okay, let me check this paper, and then I'll ask it a question. So it tells me, I think I have a collection already, but I don't know whether it has been cleared off. Okay, let me just create a new collection. So I'll click mine. Don't delete. And done. So it's going to store my PDF. The PDF uploaded to my collection. That is my collection. So let's wait for it to finish whatever it has to do. I don't know why my browser is so slow today. Let me see what happened. Okay, the customer, I think, is not working for me. I don't know what the problem is, but it's not really working for me. So, but anyways, this is very good. It's very good. I don't know whether it's my internet or anything, but I think it's not really working well. So there is SciSpace, and I uploaded a paper. It's in this collection. That is my small folder. And I'm going to ask this PDF some questions, all right? So what are the methods used in this paper? And it's going to generate the methods used for this paper. And then, so let's hold on. Yeah, so methods employed in this paper is they use all these methods in this paper, and then we can generate summary of this paper, the results, find related papers, summarize introduction, and all that. So let's try and select generate summary of this paper, and I'm going to take the mathematical models. Yeah, there's a mathematical model, so I'm going to select the mathematical models, and I would like to explain how to understand those mathematical models in the work. All right. Yeah, so this is the introduction. Summarize the introduction into points, or into head headings. I feel this is very good. This is very good. And this is the math. So the math, I'm going to take a picture of system initialization phase and I'll ask it a question. Let me see, explain. Okay, sorry. Yeah, so it's going to explain the mathematics, explain the text. It's going to explain the mathematics. You suppose you're a newbie into a field and you don't understand the mathematical expressions or the mathematical expressions used in writing the algorithms. You can use this to enhance your understanding. Yeah, so it says detailed blah 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 cyclic groups, and it says the LEA starts by doing, so it gives you, breaks down everything into bits. Now let's go to literature review. I think it's a literature review option. Let's use AI writer. I'm going to copy a text. So literature review, okay, before we use literature review, let's look for effects of GMO on humans. So it even gives you an outline. What are the effects of GMO on humans? And we're going to answer from top 5 papers. Yeah, so it says perspective chapter, GMO foods on our health, evaluation of adverse, what. And you can create columns. So this is the papers. These are the papers. These are the insights of the to the papers. Inside the papers, you can export them as CSV file or Excel file, BibTeX or XML or RIS file. And you can add a theoretical framework. It's going to talk about a theoretical framework of all these papers. I think this is similar to. I think it's the same thing. Let me be honest with you. This is very helpful. It helped me. It helped. It really helped. It was my savior. When I was writing my literature review for my thesis, I produced 218 pages thesis, my literature review. This SCISPACE was beneficial, was very helpful. I didn't stress at all. So I will encourage everyone, every student to get it. Yeah. So this is a theoretical framework. And then you can key findings. Yeah, these are the key findings. Then summary abstract. Key findings, summary abstracts, and you can even save your so here you can save your ideas. All right, save to entire notebook or select a notebook and you save to it. So that is it. This is very helpful, I must say. Very helpful. It's really saved me tons of time. And you can scroll down and see so many questions that you have for it. Generates a lot of papers on the specific topics. Now let's check on AI writer. Now start writing. The AI writer when you type in a text or you put in a text, it start writing for you. And I'm going to show you how I did this. Now I was writing an introduction for research introduction for my Internet of Things. I do Internet of Things, and then I think this one is for that thing is EV. I generated that for stuff. So let me just click on this. Okay, it's I write a bit of it and then I put it here. Now I'm going to say okay, it should be heading or let me just say AI writer. Continue writing citations, outline builder, write introduction, write conclusion. I'll say, okay, so what do you say? Write introduction, and the AI begins to write, start writing. Yeah, so the Internet of Things represents a transformative paradigm that has blah, blah, blah. Then accept, you click on accept, and then we keep on waiting. The integration of, then you click on the tab sign on your computer that is next to Q. When you click on Q, it inserts that. The integration of artificial intelligence with IoT, blah, blah, blah. Then I click on tab again and it's generating more ideas for me. All right. Then I keep on waiting. So the AI writer is going to write all these and then click on suggestion. So it's a suggestive writer. Oh, wow. It's producing more. Okay. So one thing is that for this, we can actually copy everything. Yeah, copy everything here. Maybe copy everything from just here. Copy a bit. Okay, so I can copy this and it says paragraph, cite. So I can click on cite. It looks for the citation. It's going to check on the internet and look for citations for this part. So this is very helpful. Your cite, Bentley Leo E. Hyros, Charlie Robertson, Joe Watson. Let me see outside this guy. And I think it's here. Okay. Now, one more thing is that if I don't want my articles to be flagged as an AI written article, this is what I do. This is everything in one. This is every site, sorry. And then check on the paraphraser. Paraphrase. All right. So let me see. Let me just copy the whole, all these things and see. Oh, wow. So instead, references for me. Oh, okay. So I can check the references too. I prefer the IEEE referencing style. So IEEE. Yeah. IEEE referencing style. Done. Yeah. And it shows the IEEE referencing style. Okay. So I copied this and then I go to paraphraser. Then I put it the sample text here. And I think it takes 500 words per some time. Now we have the academic, the fluent, the formal, creative, and more. So depending on your paraphrase, how you want it to paraphrase, so I'll just stick to academic. And then the length and variation. Do you want a medium, less, or do you want to sound more academic or less academic, or it should be in between? Then for the length, do you want it to expand the text or shorten? So I think we leave it like that and then click on paraphrase. So the text that it generated for us is going to paraphrase it for us. Yeah, so the Internet of Things represents a transformative paradigm. Here it says it signifies revolutionary paradigm that uses blah 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 and all that. And then one thing is that we can also look at a AI detector. Yeah, this is what I wanted to point out. Yeah, so when I put the text here, we are going to analyze if the text is actually AI generated. Now, and here you can put a minimum of 1,500 words. So we click on analyze. Now it says moderately human. So 2 out of 7 sentences were AI written. So what can we do? We can actually we can transform the text so that it will not be AI written anyway. So let's go back to our paraphraser. And then we click on this. Let me see if it's AI copy text, and let's say AI detection. It's mostly human. So this is, so the AI detection actually saw this to be mostly human. So let's cross check and see if it's mostly human AI detector. And then we click on Control A and then Control V. I reanalyze again. And let's see if it's okay. So it's mostly human. So it's able still to detect that this is AI written. Okay, so we can actually change it. Maybe change it and then new input. Okay, so Control V. Then you scan it again and analyze if it's going to, yeah. So for this, we have a tool called Undetectable AI, and we are going to humanize the text. Yeah, I can't see any part where we can humanize the text. And when you check on the paraphraser, the text mostly is mostly, it didn't say it's 100% human, it says the output text is 12% AI generated. So if you want to beat the AI model, we don't want it to be flagged as AI, I'll use a tool called the undetectable AI. And then, yeah, so for the undetectable AI, I go to the settings, I go to the page, and then put my text here, paste my text. And for this, oh my god, yeah, paste text. Okay, allow. I'm not subscribing now. Yeah, so let's see, check for AI. So when I use the undetectable AI, it's able to check your content appears human. Okay, but SCISPACE said it's still what is mostly human anyway. So let's humanize it a bit. Okay, if you want to humanize it a bit, you have to sign up. Okay, so you sign up and then you go with this. So I think this is not bad, and we have the extract data. I've not used this function before, but extract data, oh my god, this again, the extract data tool, I think when you supply it with some with a graph or something, is going to extract the data from the graph. Let's reload it and see. When I watch it, sometimes it goes off like that, it blurs out sometimes. I don't know why it's like that, whether because it's public stuff. So maybe upload PDFs. Let me see the PDF I uploaded. There's a PDF. Let me see if there's a PDF I uploaded that yeah, here. Let's see if it has a graph. It has a graph. Oh wow, so it has a graph. So we are going to extract. Okay. Upload one file. And here's a library where you can store your files. So here, I think the same paper. And let's see, extract data. Okay, so okay, so I think I want to click on something that made it upload one file. So that is the my library or chat with the network, now chat with next and the PDF. Chat with PDF is going to chat with the PDF. So okay, good. Okay, I've not used this function before. So I'm going to ask it a question. It has a copilot where we ask it some questions. And then let me just click on it and see. Okay, so summarize introduction and all that. Now we are going to ask him, can you generate the data from the graphs? Let's see if that is so that will work. Yeah, let me see. Oh, okay. I think it's hallucinating. It's hallucinating here. The AI module is hallucinating here. Yeah, it's hallucinating. So I think when you buy it, maybe you can figure it out and then see how it can be used to suit your work. Yeah. I want to look at the, let me see here, explain text and save to your notebook and results and all that. So basically this is it, and you can use these tools to enhance your research and do not waste much time, don't stress at all. Thanks for-